Well, as ever, it's great to welcome you to worship. There'll be tea and coffee following this meeting via Zoom. We look forward to seeing you there face to face. And again, I've said, if you want those contact details or you know someone who's trying to get onto Zoom and is struggling, let me have those details and we'll try and hook them up. It's really good to be able to share in that way and chat to one another. Tuesday, songs to Zoom, 7:30. That's been a really good feature and a way of encouraging one another at the same time. Friday, 7:00, there'll be another Zoom quiz. Last week's champion, so this Friday, we would have had the enjoyment of Sister Vine, who was the champion for the previous week. Who knows who it will be next week. Prayer time, again, we continue to make the hall available to you with all the conditions and requirements and that you're aware of. Monday morning, 10 till 12, Tuesday afternoon, 2 till 4, and Thursday evening, 6 till 8 p.m. Prayer is really important, whether that's your own private prayer, whether it's collective, when we're able to do that, or indeed praying for those people that we've been asked to pray for. And this week specifically, I'd ask you to pray for Kath Hammond. Kath had a couple of times in and out of hospital recently where she's not been well. And now Kath is in the Sunrise Nursing Home in Bassett. So you continue to pray for Kath and those people responsible for her care and indeed her family and loved ones. Helen Taylor has not been well this week and Helen specifically asked for our prayers. So we can do that. We can do that together. So really looking forward to worship. Today is our praise meeting. Let's go and worship. Let's praise God.
We take time now to pray, to be still before God and just to focus our minds upon Jesus. Father, we thank you today for the privilege we have of worshipping you. You are our great God Almighty, King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Just where we are, we come with thanksgiving, remembering that we are known by name and that you love us with an everlasting love. We praise you because you are triumphant. You gave your life so that we might be set free from sin. And by your resurrection, you brought us home to God. on this day we come before your throne of grace, confessing our need. Holy Spirit, dwell within our hearts. Guide us in our thinking and give us hope in these days. Speak to us, Lord, we pray, and may our lives be a witness to the fact that you are alive today. For we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, let's listen to the songsters as they sing, and that will be followed by Corps Secretary Julie Swanson as she shares her testimony.
Sing along on a Sunday morning to the songs in our worship. It's not so good when we can't meet and sing together. We haven't been able to sing at school either, and I've really missed the children being able to sing. Singing is really good for us. It improves our mood and it releases those feel-good chemicals in our brain that bring us joy. Singing brings us joy, not only to ourselves, to the people who might listen, the singer and the listener. But how much luckier are we as Christians that we can sing together and sing spiritual songs. Songs based on verses of scripture, songs that lift us up, songs that speak to us, songs that encourage us, and songs that encourage others. Singing is a really important part of our style of worship in the Salvation Army, and I know that I've had conversations with many of you about how you will miss that, and how if we do return to worship without singing, perhaps it's not for you. When we sing, it matters to us, but it matters to God too. We glorify him in our singing. We sing when we're happy and times are good, but we also should remember the spiritual strength that we can get from singing too. And I believe soon we will be singing together again. So don't forget, sing a new song to the Lord. Although at the moment, I think he's also happy with an old familiar one too.
Psalm 96, verses 1 to 3. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvellous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Amen. I wonder what kind of music you like best. What's your favourite? Maybe a bit of Freddie Mercury and Queen, or perhaps something a bit more modern. If, like me, you like a good bit of gospel music, in which case the Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir may do it for you. But bearing in mind that we're in the Salvation Army, perhaps your music of choice would be listening to either a songster brigade or a brass band. Whatever our preference is, music can be many things to many people. It can bring back memories of a person or a past event. Music also has a wonderful way of putting us in touch with our emotions, with the ability to make us laugh or cry. It can also have a calming effect on us. How many of you have turned into smooth classics after a busy and hectic day, so that you can just unwind while listening to the peaceful and restful music? Equally, it can also stir us to action. I remember visiting the Edinburgh Military Tattoo whilst at the Salvation Army's International Guide and Scout Camp. As the RAF Central Band marched up and down the castle courtyard, it certainly stirred those around me into action, and there was much stamping of feet and clapping of hands in time to the music. The opening verses of Psalm 96 urge us to sing to the Lord a new song. This morning, we can tell God how much we love him by literally singing his praises. One of the earliest records of God's children singing his praises comes in Exodus 15. The children of Israel had just successfully crossed the Red Sea, leaving Egypt and slavery behind them. And Moses led them in a song of thanksgiving, a song of praise to God for delivering them from their oppressors. We have some wonderful songs that have been written by talented and gifted people. When we sing them, our emotions are stirred and they help us to focus on the glory of God and what he has done for each and every one of us. Music can help us to express feelings that would otherwise be difficult for us to show. It's a wonderful means by which we can praise God. The singing company are now going to sing their praises to God as they bring us the song, I Have Seen the Golden Sunshine. And following the singing company, we have the second of our testimonies this morning, this time from Gloria Lewis.
Thank you. minutes to share with you from my garden. Nature, and especially my garden, is the place where I can be me, where I can find myself, and where I can connect with the Creator. At 6 o'clock in the morning, there's no better place than here when the birds are singing and everything is still. Then I can feel God's presence. Gardening and nature is an experience better felt than telt, and I think the gardeners amongst you will appreciate that. It's an experience that you have to feel. Psalm 8 reminds us of the heavens and the work of God's fingers, the stars. But it's not just the stars that I consider to connect with God. All of the beauty of his creation is the work of his fingers. In lockdown, my garden has been my safe place, helping me through the difficult patches. I can sit and gaze at God's creation for hours. When it's quiet, when it's still, then I feel his presence. More than me tending and keeping my garden is the keeper of the garden of my heart. And we read about that in our songbook, song number 502. That's a special thought, God being the keeper of the garden of my heart. Well, like life, gardening can be hard work, and we have to learn to work through the seasons and work with the seasons. And in so doing, we are working with God through the seasons of life and through his creation.
This time verses 4 to 6. For great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Splendor and majesty are before him. Strength and glory are in his sanctuary. How good are you at saying thank you? Are you one of those people who, the minute you receive a gift, immediately put pen to paper to write and say thank you? Or would you prefer to use email instead of snail mail, and you send your thanks via the internet? Maybe you like the more personal touch, and you pick up the phone and you speak to the person concerned. Or perhaps you're one of those people who always mean to do it. You're always going to do it, and it's on your to-do list. But sadly, it never makes it to the top of the list. Other things take priority, and then months later, well, it's still on your to-do list, and you're just far too embarrassed to phone or email because such a long time has elapsed. The opportunity to say a sincere thank you has passed. You may recall the stories that we heard in primary class about a God who knows even when the smallest bird falls to the ground. The storyteller would have emphasised that God loves us more than he loves the birds of the air. So who could possibly be more worthy of our gratitude and praise than God? Yet so often we take all that he gives us for granted and forget those two important little words of thank you. We started our worship this morning by singing, I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. We just need to come to him with a thankful heart and be able to recognise all that God has given us. In the Bible, it suggests that we use loud music like drums and cymbals, or soft music like harps and flutes, and music which uses our voices too. In the army, there are some songs that we tend to sing with great gusto. Accompanied by the band, we clap our hands and play our tambourines in time to the music. There is absolutely nothing wrong with that. If a song can stir us into action, then it can certainly give us a lift when we sing it, as well as being pleasing to God, of course. God chose us as his own. Surely that's enough in itself for us to show our gratitude and offer praise. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9 tells us as much. You are a chosen people, belonging to God, that you may declare the praise of him who called you. Our praise is something which each of us offers to God as a response for all that he has given and done for us. We're going to listen to the band now, and that will be followed by our final testimony of the morning, which is brought to us by our Sergeant Major, Steve Shaw.
To give a testimony, to think about how running helps me as a Christian. Let me start by saying I'm no athlete, all right? This is just for fun. I go out a little bit and I enjoy what I do, and I enjoy the company when I do it. I enjoy sometimes running on my own too, but I can just take that little bit of time in my head. So just for fun, I'm an athlete. Since the beginning of the calendar year, I've run 750 miles, just over. And I'll be out in a minute doing 5 or 6 more today and 26 tomorrow, tomorrow being Saturday. Since lockdown, more than 500 miles. So I'm out there keeping myself going. There are many parallels between being a runner, being an athlete, and being a Christian. Sometimes we picture life as a race, maybe. Many times in scripture, life is described as a race. It requires effort, it requires self-denial, it requires perseverance, all those things. Sometimes I have to dig deep. We do as Christians, we have to dig deep sometimes when we feel challenged. There's all that self-denial and perseverance that I commented on. Trust what you know sometimes. Sometimes I run on muscle memory. I'm totally shattered, exhausted, and just keep going. Sometimes spiritually we feel vulnerable, we feel threatened, we feel a little bit uncertain, and our faith is challenged. And that's when we dig into our spiritual memory and our depth. People help us, people pray with us, people support us. Do you know, during lockdown, it's been quite noticeable. I've noticed people able to share more, to say, do you know, I'm not feeling great right now. I'm really struggling with, I don't feel well. I need some prayer. And it's really good to keep that level of commitment and honesty to one another. So yeah, sometimes I'm running on spiritual memory. Other times, yeah, there's great reward. As Christians, we're just in search of that one final heavenly reward. And I run for reward. Here's one of my favourites. So during COVID, here's a medal that I ran. It was a full marathon. I did 13 loops of North East Road and Kathleen Road to get to my 26.2 miles. But it reminded me sometimes we're vulnerable. It's not as plain and as predictable as we want it to be, and there are challenges involved. Here's a medal I received. This is about perseverance, Phoenix 24. So I ran every hour, on the hour, I ran a mile for 24 hours. 3 o'clock in the morning, running up North East Road. That was different, let me tell you. It was pretty quiet too. Or maybe my first marathon, Le Mans Saint-Michel in France, from Cancale around the Bay of Le Mans Saint-Michel, where I could see the finish line, the Mont itself, from the start. We as Christians, we can see the finish line. We know what the finish line is. That keeps us going, that drives us on, that makes us want to be part of. Or one of my real favourites, this little cake stand medal with its little cupcakes that forever want to drop off. And it reminds me of just reaching out to people. When I'm running, I can reach out to people, friends that I don't know very well, perhaps I've just met in a running community that I can actually share and witness with just by maybe being me, talking about the things we talk about. Great opportunity that comes my way. So when I run, I escape. I can reflect, I can process my thinking, I can plan, I can pray. I can think about things that are important to me. I can meet those friends and new people. There's lots of social and community stuff going on, just as we would want it to be. But a bit like when the camera appears on the race and suddenly someone's taking your picture and suddenly you're fit and you're running and actually you're absolutely exhausted. So let's remember, as Christians, we can trust one another. We can take those opportunities just to share and be honest and say, right now, I need you. Right now, I need God. And that's really important to do that. So those people that we can rely on and keep us going. But you know, those parallels in scripture, sometimes all the effort that we put in, this is what it's about. This is the book of Hebrews chapter 12 and verses 1 and 2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off things that hinder and the sin that easily entangles. And let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Verse 2, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Got to go. I'm going for a run.
The concluding verses that we are going to hear from Psalm 96 this morning are verses 7 to 9. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of nations. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in the splendour of his holiness. Tremble before him, all the earth. We have heard three very different testimonies this morning. Testimonies of how music, nature and physical activity has an impact on people's lives and the way they bring an offering to God in their own individual way. In biblical times, when people entered the temple courts, they would make a monetary offering or would offer a sacrifice. These days, we are not required to offer a sacrifice in the same way as our ancestors did. We can, however, bring a monetary offering to the Lord. It seems a long time since we were sat in our hall here in Sholing, listening to piano music as the collection plates were being passed from person to person. Can you picture it? I can. Then with dignity, they were brought to the front for a member of the congregation to pray over our gift to God. Perhaps this meeting has prompted you to think, but what else can I bring as an offering to God? You can't sing. You're not a particularly good gardener, and most physical activity is beyond you. Well, let me just confess here and now that I am none of those things. Oh, sorry, I'm all of those things. However, I'm reminded of the words by Christina Rossetti, words that we would normally sing at Christmas time, which say, "What can I give him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would bring a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. Yet what can I give him? Give my heart." The suggestion is that we don't come empty-handed to our worship. We come not just to receive, but also to give. Give from our hearts, our allegiance, our love, our very lives. We're going to listen to a song now by Chris Tomlin. As he sings, think of all you have heard and listened to this morning, and make your prayer of thanksgiving and offering in the quietness of your own home.
The splendor of clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice. Trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? And all will see. How great is our God? Age to age, he stands. our God. Sing with me, have a rain.
This morning, I hope that your heart is singing, "How great is our God." And now please join me as we sing together, "Far and Near, Hear the Call." Benediction. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Good morning and God bless.